up with back in like the 2014, 2015 time era, back when I first started getting into makeup, back when I first started exploring and venturing and trying out new makeups or whatever. But today, playing in these makeups, creating this look today, just kind of had me realizing how fast things change in the beauty industry, how fast, you know, what you used to like yesterday, you're not gonna like tomorrow. What's on trend now is not gonna be on trend later. So in today's video, I am using only products I have used back in the day, same things that were the hype, and things that kind of fell off now in 2019. So if you wanted to see how I created this look, keep watching. Oh, and yes, before you ask, yes, I am filming in my kitchen. Light was bomb. Don't mind the acoustics, I don't know what that's gonna sound like yet. We'll see later when I'm editing. But yeah, anywho, keep on watching. First thing I'm going to do is prime my face. Of course, it's necessary. I couldn't decide which throwback primer I wanted to use, so I have the Honey Me Up or the Nivea Post Balm. Now, you are not a makeup guru unless you've had this. I know everybody's had this somewhere, some form. Matter of fact, both of these have been staples. You already know what time it is when you see these two as primers. I think I first started using these back in like 2014. Actually, I don't remember the first person I seen use this one, but this one was Nikki Tutorial. I think I may have forgotten how much I love these. I couldn't decide which throwback foundation I wanted to use. I think going through this, it was always down to two highlights, two concealers, two foundations, two primers, two everything. I always had like the same two that I kind of bounced back and forth between. But my two foundations today is the L'Oreal True Match and none other than MAC. I think I use these two religiously for about a year straight. This one when I wanted to be regular, this one when I wanted to have a little bit of glow. Sometimes I'll mix the two of them and like in between. So for today, I'm just gonna mix it. You know what I just realized? I did not start using a beauty blender back then. I always used a brush to apply my foundation. This was the brush that I used to apply my foundation a few years ago. This is the Real Techniques brush. Moving on. Apply just a little bit. I'm just going to mix the two. Oh my god! I have not used a brush to apply foundation in so long. This is so weird. God, I feel so complete without my beauty blender! Now it's just so awkward. I feel complete. Okay, moving on. My anxiety's on right now. I don't remember if I even attempted to do my eyebrows a few years ago, so I'm just gonna cheat for this one and use my Anastasia because in the packs. I was so addicted to this concealer. This is back when I first started even attempting to sculpt out my eyebrows. And this was so easy because I didn't put on my brush. I'm gonna take the same foundation brush and just blend that in. Why I was so hooked on this shade, because compared to my concealer that I use now, this one is definitely peachier. looking at this contour and I'm just like, I don't even really see it. But back when I used to go hard for this, this was like too much. I'm gonna take this very old Sephora brush and I'm gonna hit this powder right here. This is Max Light Sweep. And I'm just gonna lighten it. And I'm just gonna brush underneath my eyes with this. I used to do this a lot back in the day. Don't ask me why, okay? Don't ask. This is just what I wanted to do. I actually wanted to try MAC Pro Emphasize, but when I got there and I realized how real it was, they recommended Light Sweep and I've been using it. Moving on to the eyes. For eyeshadow base, I'm going to use the NYX one. This is in the skin color shade. This was long before Oprah came to play in my life. Oh, I'm just going to use this M441 brush to put it in here. For my eyeshadow choice today, I'm going to go in with none other than the Makeup Geek palette. I know a lot of people had this because this came out, I want to say, it was kind of close to Christmas time. So the colors that's in the Z palette, I did not get to choose. It actually came like as a set. And I want to say it was about $130. I'm not sure, I can't remember, this wasn't that long ago. But this is the eyeshadow throwback that I chose today because it had so many nude colors in there. And I just realized all the colors at the bottom, the kind of shimmery ones, I haven't even touched them. So, I don't really know what kind of eyeshadow I'm going for today. We're just gonna wing it, 2019. I am gonna take this extremely fluffy M501 brush by Morphe, and we are going to hit the shade Cocoa Bear. Cocoa Bear was everybody's crease color back in the day. Tell me it wasn't. I'm just gonna apply this all over the lid. Next, I'm gonna take this Real Techniques brush and we're gonna hit up, let's see, shade right here. This is called Bitten. And I'm just gonna apply Bitten on the outside. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. Just gonna keep it on the outside and I'm gonna dry it. For eyeliner today, I'm going to use none other than the Urban Decay 24/7 eyeliner in the shade Perversion, which desperately needs to be filed. For Bless Today, we are going to go in with none other than the NARS Dolce Vita. And for highlighter, we are going to take it all the way back with some MAC Soft and Gentle. For the lips today, we are going to go in with none other than LYX Lingerie in the shade French Maid. So much for taking the trip down memory lane with me, helping me dig out some of these makeup that I probably haven't even seen in so long. And I will catch you guys in